Hi, I'm Debbie with Mortgage Mom Radio, and you guys are here for Homebuyer Workshop 103. What are we going to talk about today? Well, today we're going to talk about conventional loans, USDA loans, jumbo loans, and bank statement programs. We're going to get into the loan programs that we didn't get to touch on last week in 102. So if you missed those, we talked about FHA and VA. Those are great loan programs, something for you guys to know about. So go back and watch it. 101, what did we talk about? We talked about benefits of homeownership, responsibilities of homeownership, buzzwords. What are all these acronyms and what do all these words mean? If you missed those episodes, go back and watch them. You're right here on YouTube. Everyone is about 20 minutes or so, 25 minutes, and watch what you can. It is really, really valuable education for you, and we want to make sure that you can follow us through the program. But let's get into today. What are we talking about today? All those programs that we missed last week. What are we going to talk about next week? Well, next week we're going to talk about closing costs. So if you guys like these, if you feel like they're valuable, you're just getting ready to get into the home buying process, please subscribe to our page so that you know when the next video has been published. We are trying to release these every Sunday at 11 a.m. So if you want to be here for the premiere, like you are today, you can actually start asking us questions. Start typing them right into the feed right now, and I'm going to start answering those for you. Are you a little bit embarrassed? You don't want to type that question into the feed where people can see your name on YouTube? That's okay too. How do you do that? Well, text the word MOM to 474747. You can start asking me those questions right now, right away, and I will take your question that nobody knows it was you, and I will move it over to the feed and I will answer that question for you. So however you feel the most comfortable, do it. If you're watching this video at a later date, you're not here during the premiere, no problem. Just text me your questions and I'll respond to you. So that brings me to the first thing I want to talk about, which is my phone app. How do you get my phone app? Well, you text MOM to 474747. When you do that, you can actually respond to me after I respond to you, and you can ask me your questions. You can also click on the link in the text message. The link will actually bring you to my phone app. You can save that phone app to your home screen, and now you've got every tool you could possibly need right on your phone or right on your iPad or whatever device it is that you like to use. What can you do from this phone app? So many things. There are a calculator in there is amazing. You can run a payment that's going to show you everything. It's going to show you principal, interest, taxes, insurance, and mortgage insurance if you have less than 20% down payment. So make sure you click on the right loan program for you in the calculator. At the top, you'll actually see FHA, VA, conventional, USDA as options, and make sure that that is the calculator that you're using. Hey, are you interested in refinancing? You want to know if it makes sense? There's a refinance calculator. Do you want to know if you might qualify for what you hope you can? Well, there's an affordability calculator. I'm always going to qualify you for more than what that affordability calculator would give you, but it's a great place to start. It's a great place for you on your own to educate yourself just a little bit before you give me a call. What else can you do in this phone app? Well, you can listen to the podcast. If you haven't listened to the podcast already, check it out. Seriously. We've been on the radio for 2.5 years now, almost 3 we're approaching, and our podcasts are all of the episodes that we have done during that time. There's so much valuable information there for you to listen to, especially if you're just starting to jump into the market of wanting to possibly take that leap and become a homeowner. So listen to the podcast. You can apply right online. You can do everything right through your phone. Do you want a consultation with me? Do you want to know what you can do? Do you want to know what you can qualify for? Do you need a little bit of help with some credit, credit repair, credit issues? Go to the application, click apply now. If you have the phone app, fantastic. You're going to have everything that you need right at your fingertips. So let's go ahead and move on and let's just jump right into loan programs. So like I mentioned, we've already done FHA and VA, and that was in Workshop 102. So if you missed those, please go back and go watch it, learn about it, understand it. Help yourself determine what you feel the best loan program for you is. But let's go ahead and jump right in and let's get to conventional. With conventional, you'll see that I've got Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac, a little picture for you on the page. Freddie Mac and Fannie Mae are what we consider a conventional loan. And so when you hear those terms, it kind of explain, you know, now you know what we're talking about. Freddie Mac, Fannie Mae, hey, did you get a Fannie Mae loan? Hey, is your loan backed by Fannie Mae? Okay, so you have a conventional loan or you're applying for a conventional loan. What can you do with a conventional loan? Well, you can get in with as little as 3% down payment, depending on your sales price and your county limits. you could get into that 3% down payment with no mortgage insurance. Those options are there, and it's something that we can talk about. The mortgage insurance can be removed later on a conventional loan, where an FHA loan, you cannot remove it later. It is there for the life of the loan. You would have to pay off that loan in some way, or you'd have to refinance that loan to get rid of that mortgage insurance. So that is one of the benefits of conventional. Mortgage insurance premiums with conventional can be lower than they are with FHA. If you have a credit score or FICO score, which we're going to talk about credit in a couple of episodes. I think that's workshop 105. So if you guys like what we're doing here, subscribe to the page so that you can follow us. If you do have a good FICO score, let's say it's 680 or above, you may actually end up with a lower monthly mortgage insurance premium than you would with FHA. If you have less than 20% down payment. However, if you have a lower credit score, FHA gives you one flat rate for everybody, no matter what that credit score is. So even if you had a 580 credit score, the mortgage insurance would be the same as somebody with 700. So if you have a great credit score, we may want to look at conventional versus FHA. Or if you have a low credit score, we may want to look at FHA. So it just shows you how we kind of determine which loan program is going to work best for you when you talk with us and when we do that consultation. Remember, with conventional, if you have mortgage insurance, we can actually remove the mortgage insurance without having to refinance or pay that loan off. So a couple of benefits of conventional, maybe over FHA, but there's a lot of benefits to FHA. So again, make sure you watch that last film. All right, we can close the loan with a conventional loan as a first and a second combination. Well, why would we want to do this? Okay, well, there's lots of options or lots of reasons, but why? So one of the big reasons that we would do something like this would be if someone has, maybe they want to get into jumbo territory. Maybe they want to do a big loan, but they don't necessarily qualify for those jumbo guidelines, which we're going to talk about in a little bit. We could do what's called a first and a second, or sometimes you'll hear people refer to it as a piggyback. So we're going to do a first mortgage for whatever the dollar amount is that we need, maybe the maximum dollar amount in your county. Then we're going to do a second to gap the bridge to that jumbo sales price or jumbo loan amount that you wanted so that you can fall into the conforming underwriting guidelines, which do give you more debt ratio. So we can go to a higher debt ratio and a little bit lower credit scores than a jumbo would allow. No reserves typically required if it's a primary residence. So we can do a lot more with conventional, a lot more lenient guideline than a jumbo would be. So maybe somebody that's a jumbo borrower needs us to gap the bridge with a first and second. Maybe you have a 10% down payment and you want to do a first mortgage at 80% so that there is no mortgage insurance. And then we do a second for 10%. So that we are gapping that bridge of that 20% with your 10% down payment. So lots of reasons why you would want to do this, but this is an option with a conventional loan. So next, in the state of California, which most states work this way, but I'm focusing on California only because that's where I live right now today, and that's where I do the majority of my business. I am licensed in other states, and I can absolutely help you and answer all of your questions, but that's where you just want to text me, you want to email me, or you want to call me direct, and we'll do a one-on-one consultation for you in your state and in your county. However, in the state of California, if you do put at least 10% down on a conventional loan, you can choose to have your taxes and your insurance not included in the monthly mortgage payment. Well, why would you want to do this? Well, some people are commission borrowers. Some people are self-employed. Some people get big bonuses. And maybe for them, it's better to have a smaller monthly payment recurring and then pay those property taxes when the bill comes due. Pay that insurance bill when it comes due. So it just depends on you. Now, if you're an average salaried borrower, hourly borrower, your income doesn't change, you know exactly what you're going to count on from paycheck to paycheck, it's probably easier and more comfortable to have everything rolled into one mortgage payment. That way you make one payment all the time and you don't get this big property tax bill that you all of a sudden have to come up with a chunk of money that you didn't prepare for. So again, we go through this with you personally and we determine what is the best option for you with your circumstances. So next, loan amounts up to $726,525. It does depend on the county. For example, in Los Angeles County, we can go up to this loan limit with conventional. We are considered a high balance or a high cost area, which is why they call it a conventional high balance loan or a conventional jumbo. You'll hear it referred to. It allows higher loan limits than some of the lower priced counties or, you know, lower cost areas. So for example, Riverside or San Bernardino are not going to be able to use a conventional loan up to this $726,525. So if you want to know what you can get in your county, please just give me a call or text me. Text the word MOM to 474747 and ask me that question, and I'm happy to answer it for you. Tell me the county you want to buy in and that you want to know what your maximum loan size is, and I'd be happy to give you that information. Even if you're in another state, just tell me what state and county, and I'll look that up for you and I'll get you that information. Not a problem. At the 726,525, if you are in the high cost area using a high balance loan, you can get in with as little as 5% down. So this is actually pretty amazing with conventional. Next thing is that the more lenient guidelines, which I already talked about with jumbo, we're going to be able to get you into things a little bit easier than we would with a jumbo loan. Jumbo loans are a little bit more strict in what they will or won't allow. For example, a conventional loan will let you go up to 49.9, or we call it 50% debt ratio. Now, this isn't for everybody. Depends on your credit and your income and everything about your overall loan profile, which is why we want to do a consultation with you before we determine what is your maximum budget. However, it will allow up to 50% based on you. A jumbo loan will typically cap you or limit you to 43%. So again, that's where that first and second comes in. Get a little bit creative for you and your situation. So let's move on. You've got a big jumbo elephant at the bottom of your screen. Well, jumbo's back. Actually, for a little while, jumbo had gone away and didn't really go away. It just got so tight that nobody was really writing them anymore. And that was during the recession and the drop in property values and, you know, the big boom that took place. Well, jumbo is back, and it's back in a big way. So we've got larger loan amounts with jumbo. Like I said, depending on your county, we're going to be able to take you into a jumbo loan when you exceed the conventional loan limits for Fannie Mae or Freddie Mac. So if you're in a county like Riverside or San Bernardino, you're going to be a jumbo mortgage if your loan amount is over $484,350. If you're in LA County, Orange County, Ventura County, if your loan amount is over $726,525, you're going to be a jumbo loan. And in San Diego County, it's actually, I believe, about $690. And if you want to know what that exact number is, just text me. Text the word MOM to 474747. You can always call me. Call me at 844-935-3634. Or hey, send me an email. I love email. It's so easy to get back to you. It's Debbie, D-E-B-B-I-E, at mortgagemomradio.com. But if you want to know where you're going to start into the jumbo loan process, just tell me again. What county are you looking in? And I'll let you know what that number is going to be. We can do interest only with jumbo loans. That's one of the big highlights of a jumbo loan. If you want an interest only loan, we can do it with a jumbo investor. Why would somebody want an interest only loan? Well, it depends on them. How long are they going to keep the property? Is it an investment property they're trying to get to cash flow? There's a lot of different reasons why someone might want an interest only loan. There's other reasons why maybe interest only isn't the best option. So again, that's where it comes down to me and you and talking and consulting and determining, is that an option that you may want to explore? All right, lender specific guidelines. So this is kind of what I was talking about in the conventional earlier. They're not as lenient as conventional would be. They're going to be very specific. Every single jumbo lender, they're going to have their own guidelines per lender. It's not a flat guideline that kind of goes across the board. Everybody does it a little bit differently. Some of them want to have 12 months of reserves, 6 months reserves, 24 months reserves, 18 months reserves. Depends on the lender. Some of them will not let you exceed a 38% debt ratio. Some of them don't want you to exceed 43% debt ratio. Most of them want 2 years of tax returns, where a conventional loan, not so much. We just need W-2s and pay stubs unless you're self-employed. So you're going to have lender-specific guidelines with a jumbo loan, but it's going to be something that is going to get you into lending at a much higher loan amount than a conventional loan would go to. I've seen jumbo lenders do $10 million loans. So it just depends on you. How much money do you have down payment? How much money do you have the bank in reserves? How great is your credit score? How high is it? And how low is that debt ratio? So it's something that we will talk to you about. We'll put you with the specific lender that you're going to fit into their portfolio, and we'll make sure that we get you into the financing that works best for you. All right, moving on. Let's get to USDA. Okay, so what is USDA? Well, it's the U.S. Department of Agriculture, and it is kind of the same thing that's in your meat department at the grocery store. You're riding through, you're going to buy yourself some steaks, and you see that USDA sticker on your steaks. So the U.S. Department of Agriculture does a lot of things, and one of the things that they do are mortgages. They do loans, and they do loans for borrowers that want to buy homes in rural areas, and I hope I said that right. I always mess it up. I know it's rural, but I never pronounce it right. So anyway, forgive me. But if you want to buy something with some land, and I know a lot of you are thinking, I live in California. Where am I going to find some rural property? Hey, believe it or not, there's a lot out here and a lot that you wouldn't know about. Just on the outskirts of LA, there's going to be rural property that you can get a USDA loan. Acton, Agua Dulce, Palmdale, Lancaster, Tehachapi, Lake Elsinore, Norco. There's so many areas that you could actually utilize this financing, and a lot of people don't know about it and don't understand it. Some of the benefits of USDA is 100% financing. You can literally get in the door with zero down payment. There is no mortgage insurance monthly on a USDA loan. Say what? didn't think you could get that unless you're a veteran, right? With a VA loan. You can. USDA will allow that to happen. They do not have mortgage insurance in their loans. So USDA is very good. The property does have to qualify. It's got to be in a specific area that we need to look up for you and make sure that it is considered a rural area or that it is approved for USDA financing. The other thing is that we are income based. So your income does have to qualify for USDA financing. However, USDA is extremely liberal in their income guidelines, which is great. So we're going to base it on your family size. Are you married? Do you have three kids? Does your mom and dad live with you too? And maybe your uncle? Fantastic. Now you're actually a family of eight. So based on the amount of people that are actually going to be living in the home is how they determine what the maximum income is that you can have for you and your family. So it's something that we will take you through if you are interested in this loan program. Again, all you have to do is call me. Call 844-WE-LEND for you. That's L-E-N-D and the number 4. Or text me, text the word mom to 474747 and ask me your questions. Send me an email. If you downloaded that phone app like I told you to, it's really easy to send me an email. All you have to do is hit contact us and email Debbie. Pretty cool. So USDA financing is really phenomenal. If you want to know if a property that you're interested in would be considered USDA, just call me, give me the address, I'll look it up for you, send it to me through email or shoot it over through a text message, and I would be happy to go through that with you. All right, bank statement program. This is a cool one. I love this one. This is different. So we used to have what's called stated income loans, and stated income loans no longer exist. They just don't. And it used to be that whatever your credit score was, and if you had a down payment, we could do a stated income loan, and basically you sign on the dotted line and you get your mortgage. That's not like that anymore. Right now we have what's called the ability to repay. We do need to know that you can repay the mortgage that we're going to put you into. This is going to stop us from having a massive recession in the future, ton of foreclosures, people walking away because property values drop. If we know that you can qualify to buy your home when you buy it, there's no reason for you to walk away unless there was some sort of extenuating circumstance. So we do need to figure out, do you have the ability to pay this loan? So how do we do that for our self-employed borrowers? Well, we're going to look at 12 to 24 months of your bank statements. We're going to determine the cash flow that's coming out of that. How much money are you depositing that's going in? How much money is coming out? We're going to get profit and loss statements from you to see how you're doing in your business. We're going to actually get a letter from your CPA or your financial advisor telling us what the average percentage is of your gross income to your net income on an annual basis. And we're going to determine what that monthly income is that we can give to you in qualifying for this kind of program. So we're not going to take tax returns. We're not going to look at what you filed or what you sent to the IRS. That's the upside for our self-employed borrower. It is only for a self-employed borrower. You cannot get this loan if you are employed or if you're a nurse or your doctor. No, we can't do this unless you're a self-employed nurse or doctor, which there are those, and they do have their own practices. So, you know, you do have to be self-employed. These loans are actually pretty cool because they have loan limits as high as $5 million with exceptions up to $10 million. The amount of money that you need to put down is based on the sales price of the home. We do have as little as 10% down available in this loan program, which is pretty neat. There is no mortgage insurance. So if you do 10% down, 15% down, no mortgage insurance. This loan program does carry a higher interest rate than a conforming loan or an FHA loan or a VA loan. Anything that you do actually show your true income, pay stubs, W-2s, tax returns, if you can show that income, you're going to get a better interest rate. This is an alternative type of financing, but it's getting someone into a home that couldn't necessarily buy if we looked at those, at that paperwork. So it's still a fantastic product. And once we actually do the math and determine this is what the interest rate is, but hey, you're getting in with less than 20% down and there's no mortgage insurance, a lot of time it actually works out just fine. So just something for you guys to know and to keep in mind. You can do this with a purchase or a refinance, so it's available either direction. Why do I mention a refinance? Because this is really great. There were, for a long time, there were a lot of borrowers that did get a stated income loan back in 2004, 5, 6, and 7 that have been wanting or needing to refinance, and they haven't been able to. Well, you know what? With this program, we can help you. So definitely, if you have questions, give me a call. Reach out. You guys know how to do it. Hopefully, you have the phone app. If not, anywhere at all that you guys search Mortgage Mom Radio, you can find me. Type it right into Google. I've got my website, mortgagemomradio.com. You're right here on YouTube at Mortgage Mom Radio channel. You can go to Facebook. There's all different ways to contact me, and you will find me as long as you put radio in your search. So Mortgage Mom Radio. I do want to give you an example of what I just closed. So on this bank statement program, for everybody watching that might be interested, I did just do a sales price of $1.35 million. Client was self-employed. We did the bank statement program. We did 15% down payment, and we closed his loan. So again, this is a fantastic product for somebody that can't show bank statements. It's not possible, and they really need to get into that financing. So we're done with programs. And if there is a program you want to know about, we've got no ratio loans. We have so many programs that I could spend hours and days doing this piece. If there's a program I didn't talk about that you want to know about, just reach out, get in touch with me. We'll talk about it together. We'll go through it one-on-one. All right. So this is a great place to start or stop, because I want you guys to understand, you've watched 101, you've watched 102, you're almost done with 103. A lot of you might be thinking, you know what? I can do this. She talked about 3% down. We've got down payment assistance. She talked about having a credit score. FHA only needs, you know, 580, 550. I mean, there's really not a number. We're going to underwrite you personally. So you might be thinking, hey, you know what? I really want to know what I could qualify for. And if I'm not ready today and I do have to fix my credit, or I'm not ready today because I need to show a little bit more income, being self-employed, and I don't want that bank statement program, or whatever the situation might be, you want a roadmap, you want a plan, you want to know how to move forward. This is the perfect time for you to get started with me. It's never too early to get started. And trust me, if you wait a year or 2 years when you're ready to buy, you're going to wish you had reached out to me now. So how do you do that? Go to my website. Go to mortgagemomradio.com. There's a big apply button at the top of the page. You're going to click on that. But what I want you to do is actually look at this page that I have up on the PowerPoint right now. It shows you what a wage earner typically needs to give me, shows you typically what a self-employed borrower needs to give me, and what all borrowers need to give me. So you know what? Start looking for this paperwork. Get it ready. Get it saved to your computer. Make sure you have it in a file. You can fax it, whatever you need to do, but make sure that you've got it put together, because these are the documents that I'm going to ask you for when we work on that plan, when we do that consultation with you. So get these things prepared. Okay, now back to the website. So you go to mortgagemomradio.com and you click on the big apply button on the right-hand corner of the page. And it's going to take you to a page that looks like this on your screen right now on your PowerPoint. It says apply online. Click on the button. It's that simple. create your username and password. Take you about 10, 15 minutes to fill out this piece. That's the most. Truly simple. I'm going to get a message that says that you filled out an application. I'm going to reach out to you and I'm going to say, fantastic, I received your application. Please don't forget to send me blah, blah, blah. And I'm going to give you the list of documents that were in the last previous slide and tell you what to send me. Once I have all of your items put together, I'm going to set up a consultation to work with you directly. I will not pull your credit report until we've talked first, and we will definitely chat about what you have going on and what your goals are. Maybe you want that down payment assistance. Maybe we need to work on your credit report a little bit first. Depending on what it is that you need is how we'll move forward with your consultation. But this is a great place to start. Get that application done. Start pulling together the paperwork that I need. Let's do a consultation. Let's do a one-on-one together. Let's determine what loan program is going to be best for you. Let's figure out how much will you qualify for? How much money will you need in down payment? All of that we're going to work through together. And that brings me to a really great place to talk about, you know, how do you contact me? It's up on your screen. You guys know exactly what you're going to do. It's all there. Pause it, stop it, forward it, rewind it. You guys can find me if you look at that at this screen. But this brings me to a really, really great place for me to talk to you guys about what's coming up next week. So next week, we're going to go through closing costs. Closing costs are very, very complicated. People don't understand them. They don't know how much money that they're going to need to close on a loan. They think if they've got their down payment, their 3%, their 5%, their 20%, that's all that they need. Big shock for you. That's not all you need. There are closing costs. But you know what? Closing costs can be paid for by a seller. So we're going to go line by line through a closing estimate so that you can understand what those things are. So again, if you guys enjoyed this video, if I gave you information that you didn't know before, you want to understand about closing costs next week, subscribe to my page so that way you know when there's a new video published. Every single Sunday at 11, we are going to be posting a new workshop. So you guys, check it out. Watch 101, watch 102, watch 103. Get prepared for 104. Keep sending me your questions. I'm going to keep answering them for you. How do you do that? Scroll back to my last PowerPoint and look at my contact me page. Text the word mom to 474747. And hey, if you guys want to keep asking questions, keep them coming through the feed right now. I'm not going anywhere. I'm staying here through the premiere until I haven't seen any more questions come through. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this one. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Debbie Marcoux, Mortgage Mom Radio, and we'll see you next Sunday at 11.